Hey, guess which famous marine company has just entered the electric motor marketplace? Mercury Marine.
Wow.
I met up with them at the Seattle Boat Show, got my hands on their shiny new electric outboard, the Mercury Avator 7.5E.
Hi, I'm Debbie with Mercury Marine. I'm a district manager from Wisconsin, Illinois, and Iowa.
You have been at the show now for a few days. Tell me what the reception has been like about this product. It looks so different than the other products here.
Oh, it absolutely does, and it's the electric motor. A lot of people are very excited about it. Lots of questions.
Okay, well, let's talk about the motor, and then we'll get into some of those things. And first of all, when did this product come to market?
Mercury Marine has just announced the Avator the last couple months. It will be showing a lot stronger in the future. Production is just starting now. I'm expecting to see them out in the market by mid-July, early August for sure.
I see here we've got a Mercury. It's nice white housing, different than the black that's here, so quite different. But 7.5E.
Okay, well, this is a 7.5 electric. Of course, we understand that that is not how you relate to a horsepower on the gas side. It's about a 3.5 horsepower if you were looking at gas. The electric battery will go inside. It pops in and out, just like it would be on your power drill or any of your tools like that. The battery will be a lithium battery, about 16 pounds. So overall, the whole thing with the battery and everything is going to be about 43 pounds.
It's being used in what kind of applications? It would be for dinghies, for
sailboats, kayaks, like I said, non-gas. It's been more and more asking us, because Mercury Marine is such a green company to begin with, and we're doing something every day to, you know, help make the world better and in the boating world. So in the process of doing that, why wouldn't we be doing electric? We are definitely very cautious. We're one of the largest manufacturing for innovating to the new world, to what people want. But we will also be cautious to bring the product out right and that it will perform for the boater.
Let's talk about some of the specs. So you said 3.5 horsepower equating to a gas, but what are some of the other operating things?
Testing that we've done so far, we've had it on a 400-pound boat, and at wide open throttle, it ran between 60 and 70 minutes, and then they said about half throttle, it was running between 4.5 to 6 hours, just depending on the load and the ride.
And what's the price point?
They have not announced the pricing yet, so I really can't tell you. I'm assuming it's going to be fair to the market. We do want to get it out in the market, so of course we are definitely going to make it affordable for the people who want the electric motor.
I have to ask you, does it come in any other color?
Not right now. As of right now, this is it. I think a lot of the usage on this is going to be on dinghies, and I also think the sailboat people are going to really eat this up, just like they did the 5-horsepower propane. That worked out so nice. You've got your propane tank on the boat anyways. This works out great. This is going to be so nice, lightweight. I am 100% sure it's going to be great.
Our green boater community is interested in anything that helps them enjoy boating while reducing their impact on the ocean. And as I said earlier, we're looking for 1 million boaters to change one thing. This is a great start. Get rid of your gas-consuming dinghy motor and use electric.
Oh, I think it's going to be really a nice step for them. And also, besides the fact, you know, having the battery in here, you can have another one charged. So it'll be, you know, they can stay on the water. It's not like they're going to have limited time out there. Oh, I can only run it for an hour. No, you can have two batteries and, you can go back and forth and charge and keep having fun.
Where can people go to find out more about this product?
You can do two different things. You can go to www.mercurymarine.com. And then you can also, if you want, message our Facebook. And we have somebody inside at all times that can send you any answers if you'd like, or send you brochures or whatever you'd like. We are here to communicate with them as best that we can.
And are people lining up for pre-orders? How is that being handled before it actually comes to market?
We don't do a pre-order type thing, because we do not sell direct. We're working through a distribution center, and they are working right now on how that distribution center is going to be all set up.
Well, it's just been really exciting to be here with Mercury and seeing and touching this new product. So we look forward to coming in the market. I want to thank Debbie for taking the time out of your boat show and speaking to us about this and to our green boater community.
Well, thank you very much for coming by and looking at our great new product. And I thank all the boaters out there for supporting Mercury Marine. We're here to innovate and find what you like best.
Wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you for watching this episode of the Green Boater TV. We are looking for 1 million boaters that are willing to change one thing and how they do their boating to help stop ocean pollution. Perhaps this video contained it. Subscribe to this channel for other ideas about how you can create the ocean you love.